In this video, I'm going to talk about different forms of the upper limb tension test to stress the neurological structures in the upper limbs. The upper limb tension tests can be seen as the equivalent of the straight leg raise test for the neurological structures of the upper limbs. According to Wayne et al. In the year 2003, the ULTT1 or ULTTA has a sensitivity of 97% and a spasticity of 22% in the diagnosis of cervical radiculopathy. With all of the four tests, make sure to test the good side first. The ULTT1 or ULTTA is designed to put stress on a median nerve, the anterior interosseous nerve, and the nerve roots of C5 to C7. To perform the test, depress your patient's shoulder, abduct the arm to 110 degrees, and flex the elbow to 90 degrees. Then laterally rotate your patient's shoulder, extend your patient's wrist and fingers, and slowly extend the elbow until symptoms are provoked. To confirm that you are stressing your patient's neurological structures, you can take off some tension by flexing the elbow a little, and then ask your patient to laterally flex his neck to the opposite direction, which should increase the tension again and confirm your findings. The ULTT2 or ULTTB is designed to put stress on the median nerve, the axillary nerve, and the musculocutaneous nerve. The procedure of the ULTTB is basically the same like shown in the ULTTA, except that you now depress your patient's shoulder with your hip and you abduct his arm to only 10 degrees, flex the elbow to 90 degrees, supinate the forearm, extend your patient's fingers and wrist, and slowly extend his elbow until symptoms are provoked. Again, to confirm your findings, you can create some slack by flexing the elbow and then ask your patient to laterally flex his neck in the opposite direction to create tension again. The ULTT3 or ULTTC is designed to put stress on the radial nerve. To perform the ULTTC, again, depress your patient's shoulder with your hip, then bring the arm to 10 degrees of abduction, and now flex the elbow to 90 degrees, pronate the forearm, flex the fingers, and then extend the elbow completely again until symptoms are provoked. Again, you can confirm your findings by asking your patient to flex his neck in the opposite direction. The ULTT4 or ULTTD is designed to put stress on the ulnar nerve as well as the nerve roots C8 and T1. To perform the ULTTD, first depress your patient's shoulder, bring his arm to 90 degrees of abduction, pronate his forearm, extend his fingers and wrist, go into lateral rotation of the shoulder, and then slowly bring his fingers towards his ear until symptoms are provoked. And again, you can aggravate this test by asking your patient to flex his neck into the opposite direction. Of course, you can also confirm that you are stressing the neurological structures in a different sequence. So for example, if this position is provoking your patient's symptoms, you could also ask him to flex the neck to the same side and then extend the elbow to put stress on the nerve again. All of these tests are considered positive if you are able to reproduce your patient's symptoms and if you see a marked decrease in mobility on one side in comparison with the other side. All right, this was our video on the upper limb tension test. If you suspect a cervical radiculopathy, you might want to check out our video on the cluster of Wayne right next to me, or watch our video on the straight leg raise test, which is the ULTT's counterpart for the lower limbs. As always, I hope you found our video interesting. Comment in the section down below, subscribe to our channel if you haven't, check us out on Instagram or Facebook, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.